In this video, I'll walk you through an easy way to create photo albums on Facebook in 2020, including the content you've already uploaded and brand new photos. Here we go. So you start by going to your profile page by clicking here, and then here you can see photos. The options are create the album, add the photos and videos, and edit managed existing content. So let's start by saying create album, and immediately you browse images to choose the content. So I'll pick some of these from an album I've already got on my PC. And I'll call this album the same name, which is Cruise 2017. And then add a description. You can actually say a location. It depends on where you're looking at in the video. I think it's Madeira, these pictures. So you can add those. Friends can actually contribute to the album as well, so you can add the names of people who can add their content. So you've got various sources you can go from, and you can use the date from the photos. Then you can comment on the individual pictures and click anywhere in the picture to tag people who you may recognize. So I'll just say post. Notice I've got it set to only me. It's a good idea to just post it to yourself initially, and then you can open it up to the public later. So I'll do that. A couple of basic options now available. You can feature it on your profile. You can then edit further. You can go to the settings here, download the whole album and delete it. Under edit, go back to that screen again. We can see our albums there, and we can pick out that one. If I say feature on profile, I'll confirm that. And if I now say view as, I can see that picture is now featured as someone comes through to my page profile. Now, if you were to look at the new interface on Facebook, so I'll switch to new Facebook, this is what you'll see. Again, we're still looking at the view as public here on the page, and you can see it there. If I was to go through to photos, I'll exit view as for now, and select that album again. You can see a grid view, you can see a feed view, how it looks in the feed. Grid view is the overall summary. And then edit album, edit, delete album, and edit cover photo. They're the only differences there. So we go to your photos. If you want to add content that's already there on Facebook and we want to add it to various pictures, so we can say, if I wanted to repeat the process, I'd say create album, give it a name first, and then say upload photos or videos. Now, as I look at albums, I've got an untitled one there that I haven't put any content in. So if I want to get rid of that, simply click on it. Click on the three dots, delete album, and confirm that. And notice as well as photo albums, you've actually got a story archive. So things you've done on the mobile phone, temporary stories, they're kept as well. And even videos can be stored on the page. Okay, so I've switched back to the traditional view because there's some things that you can't yet do in the new version. And that, for example, is go to existing photos. So you go to your photos, make sure it's you that's uploaded them. And if you click on them and then select the little pencil icon in the corner there, you've got the option to move to other albums. So you can say move to the one you've selected, so Cruise 2017, and be done. Whereas if you're in the brand new Facebook interface, and I select the same pencil icon, you've got edit location, that's only the actual location of where it was taken, make profile, make cover picture, but there's no move to all our albums. So that may be a feature that rolls out over time within Facebook 2020, and I'll certainly look out for that. But for now, you can, at least with the classic version, still move photos into particular albums. So that's a useful feature. Also, just to say that you can create photo albums from your Facebook page itself. So here I've got photos. So you can see the option create album there. And it allows you to add the photos from your existing files on your computer again. And if I switch to the 2020 Facebook interface, go through to photos, it's also possible to go to create album and upload photos and content there. Now, it's possible that with the classic interface back on your own personal profile, you may see things like this. So somebody, you should tag that person because they've been included. If you say no, you can go through various pictures and confirm whether or not you include them or not in the story. There does seem to be more options still available with the classic interface at the moment, so time will tell what features will become available with the newer version. But that's it from me. I'm Paul from PR Wilson Media, your social media personal trainer. Cheers!